No, honey, I didn't mean it that way. It's a huge compliment. Come on. You can understand. No. Oh, the light strands are connected. A terrible idea. Don't even switch the work.
Edna.
Side of my car, man.
Dusty, I'm so sorry. Honey.
Did you touch the thermostat? Did you turn it up?
Well, of course not.
Did somebody fiddle with the thermostat? It's 85 degrees.
85? Do you have any idea how much even a few degrees can impact the gas bill?
Of course I do. It's unthinkable.
Yeah. Curtis, what's going on in here?
Why is it so high? Someone fiddled with the thermostat.
What?
Who would do that?
What do you think you're doing?
It's roasting in here.
I like to sleep with my window open.
Hey, kid. Are you allowed to touch the thermostat at your mom's house?
Duh.
What is going on?
Hey, Fiona. She turned up the thermostat.
Said she fiddles with the thermostat at your place anytime she damn well pleases.
Is that true? Tell me that's not true. Oh, crying in the Dusty. You might as well give her your wallet and your 401k while we're at it.
Dad, do you let the kids touch the thermostat at your house?
What? No. The thermostat
is a sacred covenant. I can't believe we're even talking about this. This is madness.
You're going to keep pump faking that thing, or you're going to take a shot, Brad?
Huh? What? What? Huh?
He's never played sports ever.
Maybe it's stuck in his hand.
That's what I thought.
You know what, Dusty? You're not worth it. Come on, Dad.
Before we get started, notice we have several video and still photographers, so relax and just be in the moment.
That's so great that they do that. It's worth every penny.
Hey, kid, why don't you jump in my car so Grandpa Kirk can enjoy Pop-Pop's comedy on the way out?
Who is paying for that monstrosity?
It was Dusty's idea to cut down the tree. Yeah, and it was your idea to cut down the cell phone tower, Brad.
Yeah.
And who crushed my car with a snowblower? You did, Brad. Who crushed my car with a motorcycle?
Oh, you again!
Yeah. Well, there's a makeup Coco. Thank you. Brad! Oh, God, what are you?
Did you make TT in bed?
No, it's Coco.
Did your Coco make you TT in bed?
How would I pee upwards?
Come on, bring it on.
Where's my dad?
Dad, don't move.
There's a pack of wolves on you.
I kind of want to pet him, Dad.
Don't make eye contact with the alpha wolf.
I already did. Right in the eye.
There's nothing better than being a co-dad.
Daddy!
You got that right, Daddy. Two families working as one cohesive unit.
Are you all right?
I'm okay.
Hey, guys. We got a big surprise. No more back and forth at Christmas. We're not doing the back and forth. Nope, I just said that.
Yay!
A together Christmas like a normal family.
A together Christmas!
Hello? Grandpa Kurt?
My dad is going to stop at everything we do. Nothing's ever good enough, man.
Your father hasn't met the new evolved Dusty. I mean, who would be impressed with you?
There!
Oh, dear God. It's going to come off weird, Dusty, but he's beautiful. There you go. Why don't you bring the car around and meet you at the curb?
Right away, sir. I mean, no. I'm sorry, I'm not the driver. No, I'm Brad.
Does it step down? Why is he here?
Because my dad's coming, too.
Dad? Where's my big man?
His total lack of masculinity. I mean, his weak chin and soft underbelly bothers you not a bit.
You know, I'm just getting the feeling maybe you guys would like some privacy.
So this co-dad thing.
You gotta ask another man's permission to see your own kids.
Everything's rock solid between me and Brad here. In fact, best friends.
Really?
Brad,
thank you.
Stop it.
I'm good.
Because we're boys.
Here's the game plan. You want to be that one that she tells you about all of her problems with the guys she's actually dating.
It's called the friend zone.
No.
It's the worst advice anyone could give you. You want to be like Brad and be in the friend zone, or you want to be like Dad and get in the end zone?
Oh, gosh. Those piercing eyes. Like a velociraptor.
Don't you see what he's up to? He thinks you'll be a harboring death.
No, I'm not harboring anything.
I just want to find the perfect together Christmas tree. You don't think I can operate a chainsaw?
Ah! Cut like butter!
Hey, listen
to Brad, that's our cell phone tower.
I think Brad's dead again. Brad, don't look to the light!
Shut up! Hey, you shut up!
No, you shut up!
This is getting good, boys.
All the light strands are connected! We're running out!
Ready and wiking.
Daddy!
Don't you want to spend the holidays to one true, real dad?
I'm all the way up here just to get back at me.
Yep.
You're opening up the harbor, Daddy.
Oh, the harbor's wide open. Right. And it's Fleet Week. This is getting good, boys.
We're gonna settle this physical attack! Cut it out! This is child abuse!
That was just a snowflake!
5 more minutes and I get to be toast!
You thought that we are no longer co-dads. You gonna pump fake that thing all night? You gonna take a shot, Brad?
Huh? He's never played sports ever.
What?
Maybe it's stuck to his hand.
You want Dustin or not with?
Suck! It's all for this! Hey, how's your day?
Stepdads and dads don't always get along, but Dusty and I have this co-dad thing on lockdown.
You made treats for tonight, right?
I'll hit the bakery on the way to the pageant.
Bakery? No, so you don't want to go to the bakery.
No,
I'm assuming when you repeat what I said and you shake your head up and down, it really means you don't want me to do it.
I'm just thinking, what?
Maybe homemade?
No problem, Maddie. Homemade snickerdoodles coming right up.
Hey! All the new gang, you better cut your teeth! Thank you so much for the cup.
Look over here! Hey, kids, I got a good one for you. Two dead hookers wash up on the
table. He's not a real Christmas, Brad. I'm telling you.
The only person that can ruin your Christmas is looking back at you from that mirror.
Well, I'll see you, Brad.
Sorry. Right here. There we go.
Hmm? Still here, Brad.
I'm not sure if it's the best you've ever had.